It's too late.
No, no, no. That was not a good time.
Okay, go ahead.
Hello, I'm Ashwin, age 20, major human biology and society. I am currently in no clubs and no intramural sports. Is that a question?
Yeah, what about like labs though? Like extra?
I am all of them.
You'd like say like phlebotomy, like those all those things you do.
Okay, so I just got certified as a phlebotomist.
Oh, there we go.
I'm part of the heat lab. I work for Asian Pacific Islander Coalition for Health Against Tobacco. I do teaching with heat education for elementary school students. I mentor students with disability. I'm working with research on hypertension and the African American community in South Los Angeles.
Very cool. All right. So your name?
Oh, are we starting?
Yeah, we're starting.
Okay. Hi, Ashwin, age 21. Year in school, senior, about to graduate. And I am from the Bay Area, California, Dublin.
Mm-hmm. And then clubs and teams you were part of?
Clubs and teams. Not too many this year, but I've been a part of the Heat Lab. I go to occasional tennis club meetings or play tennis with a group. Saving Hearts, which has been pretty fun with Emily. And I was also in USIE where I got to teach my own course this quarter.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Okay. Favorite class?
Favorite class? Probably community engagement and social change. 172 on health disparities.
Nice. Okay, so what was your favorite class?
Favorite class I took. The class I'm in now is pretty interesting. It's society and genetics, where we're learning about genetically inherited diseases and the backgrounds of how genes are transmitted, and also the societal and medical issues attached with genetic diseases, genetically modified technologies such as CRISPR and
Wait, that's cool.
Which is really interesting. Mm-hmm. And research ethics.
Right, that's cool. And then favorite food place?
Food place? I've been eating at Kava a lot.
Oh, okay. Ooh. What about on campus?
B plate.
Okay, and then favorite food place?
Favorite food place? Still probably Sunin. From all the times we went. Mm-hmm. I guess also not just the food, but how it became something that we went to every year, every quarter almost.
Yeah. Yeah. And then favorite spot to do nothing?
Favorite spot to do nothing? I have a lot of those. My room.
And then favorite spot to do nothing on campus?
Favorite spot to do nothing? I would probably say the botanical garden.
Oh, that's a nice one. Oh.
And just sitting at the picnic benches or walking around is something I like to do, especially on a hot day. It's a nice, cool place outdoors.
Mm-hmm. Okay, nice. Favorite spot to study?
Anderson Library.
The shade. And then favorite spot to study?
Favorite spot to study, Anderson Library. Especially this year when it was raining, we were able to, I don't know if you went too, but you could see all the rain pouring down through the giant windows.
Wait, that's
and
cool.
I was there so many times when it was raining and it was really nice.
Mm-hmm. And you were there pretty late sometimes.
Pretty late sometimes, but the rain was really nice, except for the leaks and the roof.
Oh, damn. Favorite day of the week?
Saturday.
Okay, favorite day of the week?
Favorite day of the week in general? Probably Fridays. I like Fridays, where you get a little bit of school, but then also the start of the weekend.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Favorite song?
Favorite song? I've been listening to El Mismo Sol by Alvaro Soler.
And then favorite song?
Favorite song? I'll say Bajo El Mismo Sol.
I love that song.
Favorite moment? From when?
Part of the year, like the school year.
Top of Cactus to Clouds, now that we made it.
Yes! I forgot that was this year. And then favorite moment or part of the year?
Probably when I went to Zion National Park. It was a great break from school and studying, and it was really beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Okay, describe someone you see all the time, sorry.
There's this one person that claims to be, was in the same club that I was in. And I've seen this person multiple times, but I never seem to recognize who the person is. And I'm usually good at that, but I'm very surprised because this person, I just don't recognize. Ever.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Okay.
Future me, let me know if you ever again.
Nice. Okay, and then what's something new you tried?
New I've tried. Well, there's a couple of things. I guess one could be a pink watermelon. Pink pineapple.
Oh yeah.
And I tried a white strawberry.
Oh, nice.
As in fruits.
Cool. And then what are your summer plans?
I will be taking the MCAT this summer and hopefully not doing it ever again.
Nice. Okay. Describe a person you see all the time. I don't know.
There's someone that was in one of my clubs 2 years ago who remembers me, and I see them often and they always say hi. But I don't even remember if they were from that club, for sure. But I always say hi back, but I don't know who they are.
Damn!
But it's so sad. I wish I knew. But,
nice. You could ask them.
If I run into them.
Okay, and then something new you tried.
I got to teach my own course this quarter, which was definitely a new, really amazing experience.
Mm-hmm. And then, summer plans.
Summer plans. Hopefully I get to do research in a lab back at home. But I'm also planning to possibly travel to India for a little bit this summer to visit grandparents.
Nice. That's cool.
And writing medical school secondaries.
What? There's more?
Yep. There's about 200 essays I have to write, at least.
What have you learned? Something.
Yes. I think this year I've really been able to figure out what I want to do in the future too, as well, in terms of broadening my understanding of social justice issues and health in the broader community. Also, talking to more people is something that I've done, reaching out to professors and people that have, I guess, my mentors or instructors more this year, and found people that have a lot of similar beliefs and similar interests, which have been very interesting.
Cool. Yeah. What have you learned this year?
I think something that I've learned is, even when setting goals or something that you want to accomplish, I think it's really important to be very intentional in what you do. I think from this experience, I learned that, even for example, I spent a lot of this year studying, and I think things can be planned a bit better and more organized, which is something I wish I did more of.
Okay.
And also, I don't know if this was part of the question, but I wish I was able to plan everything and still say yes to things and be more present in events outside of academics and school. And I think I definitely could have made that possible if I was more intentional about doing it that way.
And then, how have you changed?
I think this year I've been more focused and more realistic on what I need to do in order to achieve my goals compared to last year. And I think in a way that's a really a good thing. And I'm glad that I used all of last year to explore and have fun and introduce myself to college before this year.
That's good, yeah, cool.
Changed over the year. I guess in a sense, I have been a bit more focused on future career and goals this past year, which has been a change. I think the past couple years I was just mostly enjoying and doing a lot of things, and then this year has been a lot more focused.
And then how often do you call your family?
Every few days, every 3 days at least. And I guess they're sort of my counselors for any issues or anything that I want to get out.
That's nice. Cool. And then how often do you call your parents and how much do you share?
I call them a couple times a week.
Nice.
It changes every week, but it could range from a 1 minute call to all the way to an hour or two long call, depending on the day. But I still call them pretty often.
Nice. And then, what is something you do you wish you did more?
I haven't been able to go outside and go hiking, try out camping more. And it's something that I want to do more next year.
Nice. You kind of said this, but something you do you wish you did more often?
Yeah, I wish I said yes to things more often and tried some new things, whether it be... I wish I went on more hikes this year, too. I went on very few. And also maybe took part in more sports or game nights. I recently went to... board game night a couple days ago and it was so much fun, so I wish I went to more of those. And I'll definitely be trying to do that more in the future.
Nice. Where do you see yourself 1 year from now?
I think 1 year from now, I have a couple plans, let's see how this plays out, but I see myself teaching a course for undergrads, hopefully I'll see some friends there. I see myself being very close to the finish line of graduating college. I have plans for my gap year settled and something, a lot of fun stuff to do for that summer and that year.
Where do you see yourself a year from now?
A year from now, hopefully I have gotten into medical school. Yeah. We'll see. I'll watch this video. Better get in. But yeah, hopefully nice. That's where I'm at.
Nice. And then what's a goal for this year, 1 year from now?
I guess the goal is to really figure out what activities and what things I'm really interested in, and also figure out my capabilities. I think another goal aside from school that I have is I really want to focus on getting back into athletics and fitness and having a goal of going to the gym and working on those other talents outside of academics that I'm really interested in. I want to work on becoming a better chef, learning new recipes, cooking better. I want to learn, I want to become better at Chinese, Mandarin, be able to work on my Spanish, my Hindi, different languages. Hope maybe become a phlebotomist. We'll see where it goes.
And then a goal you would like to accomplish?
I want to learn a new language this year.
Oh, which one?
I don't know for sure. For one, I am going to try to learn Spanish again really well this upcoming year, and potentially one more. It might be American Sign Language, but we'll see. Maybe a different one.
And then what about 5 years from now? Where do you see yourself?
5 years from now, I am hopefully finishing medical school.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see where I'm at, but I'll let the journey guide me.
Mm-hmm.
For now, that's the goal.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Nice. Mm-hmm. And then where do you see yourself 5 years from now?
5 years, hopefully in medical school, probably match time. So I'd find out what career I'll be doing for the rest of my future and find out where I'm going to be working for the rest of the future as well.
That's crazy. Whoa. So that happens like year four?
Year four. Whoa. Your final year.
Cool. All right.
Oh, I don't remember your question.
What's something you'd tell yourself a year ago?
Something I'd tell myself a year ago is don't worry about the future as much. Just stay very focused on what you want to do. Whatever that goal is, achieve it. And I think don't be lazy.
Nice.
And work out. Stay exercised. Don't get a bus pass.
Don't take the bus.
Don't get a bus pass. Something bad will happen if you take a bus. I only work on threats.
Oh my God. Nice. Okay. What's something you would tell yourself a year ago?
Start studying for the MCAT and take it in the summer and be done with it.
Oh,
September 9th was actually a pretty easy exam. You should have taken it then and been done.
Damn.
But yeah. And then have fun during your senior year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Too late now. Uh-huh.
Hey.
Too late
now. You had some fun. And then, yeah. But it's a lot of study. Okay. And then what's your favorite thing about yourself at the moment?
Favorite thing, I am very glad that I'm taking the initiative to do a lot of things that I enjoy as well.
Nice. What's your favorite thing about yourself?
Favorite thing, I think probably the way I think about things.
Like in what specific way? What is the way?
I think I think about things pretty deeply. And it always keeps me intrigued in some aspect.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
And so I like that.
And then, what do you want to do with your time here?
Earth?
On Earth while you're alive.
Let's see. I guess a goal for everyone, reaching a state of self-actualization. Being content with yourself, feeling like you made an impact both on yourself and the community around you. Feeling content with the things you've explored and the things you've done. And still always have goals. And have no regrets.
Nice.
Fewer minimal regrets, I guess.
Cool.
Yeah, my contact lens is falling off.
Oh, okay.
That's the end?
Yeah, nice. Okay. Thanks for doing this. Okay. Right. And then what do you want to do?
Oh, in life? I hope to try a lot of different things, and one of the biggest things is always stay engaged and motivated to do stuff. I don't want to be old and then just give up on everything, but always have something to look forward to and something that I'm working on to keep me up and going.
Nice. Awesome.
Okay, cool. Bye-bye. Thanks, B, for making these. Yeah.
Del este hasta oeste y bajo el mismo sol.